I thought AI development had plateaued. I thought the bubble was about to burst and the hype train was derailing. I even thought the software engineering jobs might be safe from being automated. But I couldn't have been more wrong. OpenAI released a new, terrifying state-of-the-art model named O1. And it's not just another basic GPT, it's a new paradigm of deep-thinking reasoning models that obliterate all past benchmarks on math, coding, and PhD-level science. And Sam Altman had a message for all the AI skeptics out there.
Two steps ahead. I am always two steps ahead.
Before we get too excited about the possibility that O1 will unburden us from our programming jobs, there are many reasons to scrutinize this new model. It's definitely not ASI, artificial superintelligence. It's not AGI, artificial general intelligence, and not even advanced enough to be called GPT-5. Despite its mission of openness, OpenAI is keeping all the interesting details under wraps. But in today's video, we'll try to dissect how O1 actually works and what it means for the future of humanity. GPT-5, Q-Star, Strawberry. These are all names that have leaked out of OpenAI in recent months, fueling speculation and excitement. But on 12th of September 2024, the world was taken by surprise when they released O1 ahead of schedule. GPT stands for Generative Pre-trained Transformer, and O stands for, well, maybe,
oh, we're all going to die.
But first, let's examine these impressive yet somewhat dubious benchmarks. Compared to GPT-4, O1 achieves massive gains in accuracy, most notably in PhD-level physics and on the massive multitask language understanding benchmarks for math and formal logic. But the most astonishing improvements come in its coding ability. At the International Olympiad in Informatics, it was in the 49th percentile when allowed 50 submissions per problem, but then broke into the gold medal territory when it was allowed 10,000 submissions. And compared to GPT-4, its CodeForce's ELO rating skyrocketed from the 11th percentile all the way up to the 93rd percentile. That's a monumental leap. They've also been secretly collaborating with Cognition Labs, the company that aims to replace programmers with their AI assistant named Devon. When using the GPT-4 architecture, Devon only solved 25% of coding problems, but with O1, that success rate jumped to 75%. That's astounding, and our only hope is that these internal, closed-source benchmarks from a VC-funded company eager to raise more money are perhaps a bit exaggerated. Only time will tell. But O1 is undoubtedly a significant leap forward in the AI race, and the timing couldn't be better. Many people have been switching from ChatGPT to competitors like Claude, and OpenAI is reportedly in talks to raise more capital at a staggering $150 billion valuation. But how does a deep-thinking model like O1 actually work? Technically, they've released three new models: O1 Mini, O1 Preview, and the full-fledged O1 Regular. Most of us only have access to Mini and Preview, while O1 Regular remains exclusive, possibly behind a rumored $2,000 Premium Plus plan. What sets these models apart is their reliance on reinforcement learning to perform complex reasoning. When presented with a problem, they generate a chain of thought before presenting the answer to the user. In other words, they think through the problem step by step. René Descartes once said, "I think, therefore I am." But O1 is still far from being a sentient life form. Like a human, though, it goes through a series of thoughts before reaching a final conclusion. During this process, it produces what are called reasoning tokens. These are outputs that help the model refine its steps and backtrack when necessary, allowing it to produce complex solutions with fewer hallucinations. The trade-off, however, is that the responses require more time, computing power, and money. OpenAI released a slew of examples, like one where the model creates a playable snake game in a single shot, or another where it generates a nonogram puzzle. The model can even reliably tell you how many times the letter R appears in the word in and strawberry. A question that has baffled language models in the past. Well, at least that's what they claim. When I tried it myself, it still tripped up. Interestingly, The actual chain of thought is hidden from the end user, even though you're paying for those tokens at a price of $60 per million. They do provide some glimpses of the chain of thought, like in a coding example that transposes a matrix in Bash. You'll notice that it first analyzes the shape of the inputs and outputs, then considers the constraints of the programming language, and goes through several other steps before producing a response. But this isn't a novel concept. Google has been dominating math and coding competitions with models like AlphaCode and AlphaZero for the past few years, using reinforcement learning and synthetic data generation. But this is the first time a model like this has been made generally available to the public. It's pretty clear that despite the advancements, this model isn't truly intelligent. That being said, there's immense potential with this chain of thought approach. And by potential, I mean the potential to overstate its capabilities. Back in 2019, they were telling us GPT-2 was too dangerous to release. Now, 5 years later, we've got Sam Altman urging regulators to keep an eye on AI developments. Scary stuff indeed. But until proven otherwise, O1 is just another sophisticated AI tool. It's essentially GPT-4 with the ability to recursively prompt itself. It's not fundamentally game-changing, but then again, who am I to judge? I'm just like a horse influencer in 1910 telling fellow horses that cars won't take their jobs. But maybe a horse driving a car will. But there's something else we need to talk about: the ripple effects this could have on the tech industry. Remember when AI was just about beating us at chess or Go? Now it's knocking on the door of complex problem solving that we thought was uniquely human. And let's not forget the ethical can of worms this opens up. As O1 inches closer to mastering tasks that were once the domain of highly skilled professionals, we're forced to ask ourselves, where do we draw the line? For instance, what happens when these models start making decisions that have real-world consequences? If O1 can generate code that powers critical systems, how do we ensure it's free from bias, errors, or even malicious intent? And if it's capable of refining its logic through this chain of thought process, who's to say it won't eventually start making judgment calls that we haven't explicitly programmed it to make? You might be thinking, that's a bit of a stretch, isn't it? Maybe. But history has a way of sneaking up on us. Just look at how quickly AI went from amusing chatbots to disrupting entire industries. Now we're talking about AI that can potentially outthink us in fields we spent decades mastering. It's a sobering thought. Then there's the economic angle. With O1 raising the bar, it's not just about improving AI capabilities, it's about who gets left behind. Smaller companies that can't afford the exorbitant costs associated with models like O1, remember that $2,000 premium plus plan, might find themselves edged out of the market. This isn't just a tech arms race, it's an economic one. And if history has taught us anything, it's that these kinds of shifts often come with unintended consequences. We could be looking at a future where access to top-tier AI becomes the dividing line between the haves and the have-nots. Now, OpenAI's not oblivious to these concerns. They've been pretty vocal about the need for regulation and ethical oversight. But here's the kicker: AI development is moving faster than policy can keep up. By the time regulations are in place, who knows what O1 or its successors will be capable of? We're racing down a highway with no speed limits, and the destination is still a giant question mark.